So don't you think you also deserved that chance to probably play for India once again?
You know, I was very close to getting selected when Shikhar Dhawan got selected. But somehow, you know, I missed the bus.
Our today's guest is one of the legends of the game and unsurprisingly hails from India. From being the youngest cricketer to have scored a triple century in Ranji Trophy, to have represented India in 31 tests and to have dominated domestic cricket with utmost pride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed my honor to welcome a very special guest, Mr. Waseem Jaffer, on the show. Hello Waseem bhai, how are you?
I'm good, Vedant. How are you?
I'm doing well. How is everything back there?
Everything is completely the same since last 3 months. So hoping for the better things ahead.
All right. Firstly, many congratulations, Waseem bhai, on being appointed as the Uttarakhand's head coach. How's the feeling and how are you planning for this new phase?
It's quite exciting, something which is very new to me, even though I have tried my hand in coaching, but not as a head coach. I've done some batting consultancy and I played some part in the coaching, but taking up the whole team is quite exciting and challenging to me. So I'm looking forward to it.
Great. Waseem bhai, you have been around for a while and you have seen ins and out, you've seen ecstasy turning into agony. You have played so many memorable knocks in your career. How were you so consistent?
To be honest, actually, I was not that consistent. Otherwise, I would have played more than 100 test matches. I was not that consistent at international level. That's why I got dropped. But I was consistent in the domestic front, obviously. A lot of people know me, or you know, I've got famous for my first class career more than the international cricket that I played. But I've been fortunate, you know, the love for the game, the love for batting, and that is the only thing I feel, you know, I know. I don't know much other than, you know, skills, other than playing cricket. So that's why probably I didn't left it earlier. I wanted to, you know, continue it as long as it's possible. And it's also my, you know, bread and butter. You know, that is the only way, you know, I can earn money. I've got job through cricket. So I didn't want to let it go so easily. And that love for the game has remained, you know, up until last year when I retired, when my body has, you know, kind of given it up. So still, you know, I want to stay involved with the game, be it into coaching or, you know, some other capacity. But, you know, this game is something which has given me everything, so I want to stay connected with it.
Since you are absolutely right, since you are talking about the first class cricket and domestic cricket, I want to ask you a question. You had so much success with Mumbai. What made you shift to Vidarbha?
I think it was about time. I thought I was not going to play for India at that time. You know, in my mind, I knew that I was not going to get selected. And it was about time that, you know, I tried, you know, challenging myself. There were a lot of youngsters who were coming through in Mumbai. And I didn't wanted to, you know, take up their place. And I kind of got few signals, you know, from selectors or from, you know, the coaches that, you know, they might drop me in the one-day tournament or maybe in T20 tournament. So I thought, you know, before they could do it, you know, it's time to leave it gracefully. And find some new challenge for myself. You know, if I want to extend my career, even though I kind of was getting the offers from 2008, but I kept on refusing them because I was made captain of the Mumbai team, and I captained them for 3 or 4 years, and I was still enjoying at Mumbai. It's not like that, but you know, at 2014-15, I kind of got the signal that you know. The youngsters are coming through, so you know they might think about dropping me from some format. So I thought it was time to move on, and good that, you know, I kind of decided on Vidarbha and the kind of things that Vidarbha, you know, went on to achieve, which I feel very happy and proud about.
You won't believe. Other day I was talking to Fez Fazil and he was saying, oh, he had all praises for you. So that's something that you have earned. Waseem bhai, I want to ask one question. You have dominated so much and last few years were really good for you. Don't you think you deserved a chance to make a comeback? Because there have been players who did well in the domestic circuit and were able to make a comeback for India. So don't you think you also deserved that chance to probably play for India once again?
I think I definitely performed. I definitely performed after I dropped from 2008. The very next season, I was the highest run getter in Ranji Trophy. I got 1,200 runs the same season. I was the Ranji captain. We went on to win the Ranji Trophy. I was the captain in West Zone. We went on to win the Dilip Trophy. And even in 2012-13, even then, you know, I was very close to getting selected when Shikhar Dhawan got selected. So I came very close, you know, a couple of times or even more. But somehow, you know, I missed the bus, which I don't know, which probably the selectors will are the best people who can answer that. But I definitely, you know, kept knocking the doors, never got a look in. So no regrets at all.
All right. Waseem bhai, you have seen so much and that's the reason I want to ask you this question. So many Indian cricketers or probably young buds will be seeing this video. Don't you think Indian cricketers should start playing overseas test matches a little more in terms of county cricket, if I specifically talk about?
Definitely. I think county cricket, as and when players get chances, they get breaks during their tough schedule. I'm sure, you know, they must try a hand in playing county cricket. I think it gives you a different perspective. There's so many changes that happens in England weather and English conditions. And there are, I mean, we've got history of players who have played number of seasons in county cricket and have excelled. And that's where they have improved, you know, playing in different conditions. Zahir Khan is a prime example. When he came back after, you know, the Worcestershire stint, he was a different bowler altogether. So I feel, you know, Pujara keeps on going as in when he gets chances. Ajinkya Rahane has went. Rohit and, you know, obviously Virat was supposed to go for Surrey, but, you know, because he got injured, he didn't go. But I feel, you know, because these guys play so much cricket, so, you know, I understand, you know, somebody like Rohit or somebody like Virat, they play three formats and they are busy right throughout the year. So it's very hard for them to go and play county cricket. But other than that, I feel somebody who's young and, you know, want to learn the trade in their initial years of their international career, I feel they should definitely go.
And Waseem bhai, how different is India's domestic structure as compared to England's? And what are the changes that India's domestic structure actually needs?
I think our structure is not bad, to be honest. I just feel we need a bit of more continuity. I feel, you know, every year we keep on changing, you know, whether we start with Ranji Trophy, start with Vijay Hazare, and sometimes we start with, you know, T20 tournament. So I think we just need a little bit more continuity. I feel we should always start a season in October with Ranji Trophy because that is the time. I feel, you know, in July and August, September, a lot of teams that go on and play pre-season tournament, they go on and play 3 and 4 day tournament and they practice with red ball. So that makes sense to, you know, continue with the same format and start with Ranji Trophy.
Absolutely.
And then with the Ranji Trophy, when this Ranji Trophy finishes, you know, have the Irani Trophy straight away after the Ranji champions versus the rest of India. And then I feel, you know, you can put probably T20 tournament, you know, after the Irani Trophy, because that's the time probably that auction happens. So a lot of franchise people can see that tournament and probably, you know, scout and pick up, you know, few players, they'll be up for the grabs. And there's a lot of motivation for the youngsters also to play that Syed Mushtaq Ali if the auction is after that. And then finish the season with Vijay Hazare, a 50-over tournament. I feel we need to stick to this kind of, you know, format. Other than that, I feel, you know, there's not much. I feel we can get away with, you know, probably Dilip Trophy. I feel, you know, it's about time that, you know, we don't play Dilip Trophy and use those 1.5 month or a month to give the players a little bit more break There was a trophy, I can understand it. It only takes 5 or 6 days, so it doesn't take you a lot of time. But I definitely feel that, you know, Dilip Trophy should go. Other than that, I feel, you know, most of the tournament are, you know, most of the things I feel in domestic structure are well in place.
And Waseem bhai, how exactly are you seeing this season? Because of the outbreak of coronavirus, there will be some changes. So do you think that what you have exactly mentioned, Ranji Trophy, which is start with Ranji Trophy and then move to the white ball, do you see this happening during this season?
No, I feel when we'll start the season this year, we'll definitely, I feel, start with IPL, because IPL probably will happen, you know, as and when the cricket starts. And probably after the IPL, I feel that T20 tournament, the Mushtaq Ali tournament might happen, because there's a very big auction happening in December or January. So it makes sense this year to keep the IPL, after the IPL, keep the Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy straight away. So, you know, again, as I said, you know, a lot of people will get, you know, to scout a lot of younger players, because such a big auction is going to happen next season in December or January. So it makes sense to play Syed Mushtaq Ali at the start. And then after that, I feel, you know, once the Syed Mushtaq Ali is finished, then we can start with Ranji Trophy. I feel we can get away. We can get away with Vijay Hazare Trophy or Deodhar Trophy or Dilip Trophy this season. Just have Syed Mushtaq Ali and the Ranji Trophy. I think, you know, just to put in all the matches and probably give enough breaks to the players also.
But how do you think it will monetarily affect the cricketers who are only relying on domestic cricket performances? Or are the matches?
I think somewhere we need to give in something. You can't have everything, you know, on your plate, because we are not going to have the season until December. If IPL happens, probably, you know, that is going to take good 6 to 7 weeks, and after that probably you need another couple of weeks to start the domestic season. So I feel there's a lot of, you know, little time to keep all those matches. I can understand, you know, your question, but I feel we can't have everything before March end, because the next IPL is going to happen in first week of April, and to fit all those matches in such a short span of time, it's not very possible.
Absolutely. Waseem bhai, there is one more question. You have seen so much, and we have seen that IPL started back in 2008. But before that, every cricketer was willing to perform in the domestic circuit, probably get a chance. If he performs well, he will get a chance to play for the national side. But everything has changed after that. From 2008, the performances in IPL is seen more than the performances we see in domestic circuit. There are so many cricketers who actually perform in Deodhar or Vijay Hazare, but the limelight on IPL is too much. What is your say on to it?
I think there's nothing wrong with that. Probably, you know, because it's such a big stage, you know, for the younger players to get themselves noticed, because you're playing with the best and you're playing against the best of the best. And if you, you know, show your temperament, if you show your skill and, you know, have few good matches, then suddenly you get noticed. You know, players like Bumrah, Hardik Pandya, to name a few. If they had not played IPL, I'm sure we wouldn't have noticed about them. So, you know, that is the beauty of IPL, that, you know, it gives you that platform to, you know, perform for a lot of youngsters, and there's nothing wrong in that. But to pick a player in Test cricket because of his performances in the IPL, I think that is something which is wrong. I think if he performs well in the IPL, maybe we can look at him in the white ball format. But definitely a red ball cricket is totally altogether skill set wise and the temperament wise. So I don't think there's anything wrong with that player, you know, focus themselves, you know, that they want to stay fit for the IPL, they want to play IPL. I think there's nothing wrong in that, because it gives you, first of all, it gives you that monetary benefit. And plus it gives you that stage to perform. I mean, if you have few good games, you can go to the next level straight away. Whereas, you have 1,000 runs in Ranji Trophy, but there's hardly people watching. So there's definitely, there is a lot of, you know, positives of, you know, playing in the IPL, but I feel that youngsters need to, you know, keep their priorities right. You know, there is a lot of space for playing first class cricket also, and there's nothing wrong in focusing on the IPL and white ball cricket, but you need to, you know, prioritize the things.
Wasim bhai, as you said about IPL, I think in today's world, 60 of 30 is highly regarded than 30 of 60, more because of the evolution of game. But do you think it's a long-term approach?
No, I think you need, as I said, you know, a lot of youngsters, I think my kind of advice to all the youngsters is to fit in all three formats. You know, there's nothing wrong in hitting 30 balls 60. But when you're playing four-day cricket, you need to bat for 60 balls to get 30 runs. You're not going to get 30 balls 60 in four-day cricket. So you need to understand what kind of format you're playing, and you need to prepare for that format, and you need to have that skill set and that temperament for that format. You can't just play one way. You're not going to succeed. So different format requires different temperament, different skill set. And you need to have those. You know, there's prime example of Virat Kohli, Joe Root, Steve Smith, Williamson, Mitchell Stark, Rabada. If I come into the bowler section, they all play all three formats, and they know how to perform, and you know what to do, what in which format. So there's no excuse for you to say that, you know, I can't play in four-day stuff, or you know, if I play four-day stuff, I can't, you know, manage in T20 stuff. So these are the adaptations you need to do in this day and age.
Wasim bhai, another important question. A few days back, we saw Suresh Raina, Yusuf Pathan, Robin Uthappa, a lot of cricketers coming forward and saying that BCCI should allow non-contracted players to probably go and play overseas T20 league. What is your say onto it?
I think it makes sense to me. I think if you are not centrally contracted player, then I think you should allow them. You can't restrict each and every player. You can probably minimize them to, you know, two leagues. You can pick and choose two leagues probably and then play. But just to not let any Indian player not play anything other than IPL, I think it's a little bit harsh in my opinion.
All right. Last question before we move to the rapid fire round. How about you make your all-time Test 11?
I think it's going to be hard, Vedant, you know, primarily because, you know, there's some great players who have played, you know, somebody like Bradman, who we haven't seen live, but, you know, his record and all that, you know, if he doesn't make, just because we haven't seen, or somebody like Barry Richards, you know, who was so prolific when he played county cricket or, you know, world cricket, world 11, but he only got to play only four test matches. So it's hard to pick. But if I need to pick somebody, you know, from probably 1970s or 80s, then probably you can pick it. But it's never going to be the best 11.
Current side. So current players who are playing, only they.
I think it's going to be hard straight away if I need to pick. I'll definitely pick Virat Kohli without a doubt.
Right.
I'll definitely pick Steve Smith. Kane Williamson, Babar Azam is going to be there without a doubt. If I need to pick a keeper, I'll probably pick Josh Butler. Shea Hope, I think he's also a very, you know, fantastic player. He might be there. Pat Cummins in the bowler section. Pat Cummins, Jasprit Bumrah, Rabada, Ben Stokes.
All right.
If I need to pick a spinner, probably Nathan Lyon is definitely, you know, is a definite pick. So these are the players probably in my mind that comes straight away.
11. That makes a very good Test 11. You started with Virat Kohli, Steve Smith, and ended up being a very, very good Test 11. All right, Wasim, I will move to the rapid fire round now. Not much time. We'll straight away go to the rapid fire. Your fondest memory on the cricketing field?
I think getting the test cap, you know, would be one of them, without a doubt. Becoming a test player for India, very honorable moment for me. Probably getting that 300 on my second Ranji Trophy match, that is, you know, one of the very special moments in my life. Winning the Ranji Trophy for the first time as a captain, I feel, in 2008, I was the first time captain in Mumbai, went on to win the Ranji Trophy that season. I think those are the three, and probably the first season of Vidarbha, when we won the Ranji Trophy that season, 2017-18, I think that was also very special. To see, you know, somebody, some state which hasn't won at all, and you know, that new territory, and you know, for the younger players to achieve that was very special.
All right. Your favorite stadium?
In India, I would say Dharamsala, just for the picturesque, you know, for the beauty that it possesses, even though I haven't played there much. After that, probably Eden Gardens is a special place.
And what about overseas?
Overseas, I would say Cape Town. Definitely Cape Town is one of them. Lords, you know, for its history and, you know, everything else that surrounds with Lords. Adelaide Oval, Australia, I think that is a fantastic ground as well.
Okay. A tough one. Virat Kohli or Steve Smith, who is a better captain?
Better captain, I won't be able to tell you. I mean, because I haven't played under them, so it's hard to judge it from the outside. I mean, Steve Smith is not... I think it's hard. I think it's very, very hard to judge. Steve Smith is not a captain anymore. And, you know, Virat is leading the team. You know, he's become the tester. He's become number one. We were the first team. So I would have to give it to Virat Kohli because, you know, he's achieved, you know, the first Asian team to win in Australia. And, you know, the kind of probably intensity and the fitness that he's brought into their Indian culture and Indian players' culture, which is amazing to see.
All right. One youngster you feel will definitely make it big and play for India?
I think Yashasvi Jaiswal.
All right. Your favorite cuisine?
It has to be Mughlai. Mughlai, definitely. I like, you know, the Afghani food also. So, I'm not much of the other cuisine, you know. Some people like it Japanese or, you know, those others. But I like it, you know, my own style, the Indian style.
All right. One moment you would want to bring back in your career?
Obviously, you know, probably looking back, I would say, you know, if I wished, you know, to have a longer career in international, longer and successful international.
All right. Now I will give you five batsmen and you have to rate them in ascending order. The batsmen are Rahul Dravid, BVS Lakshman, Ricky Ponting, Sachin Tendulkar and Viv Richards.
I think probably Viv Richards would take number one spot in my mind. Sachin would be second. Rahul Dravid would be third. Ponting would be fourth. And Lakshman will be fifth.
All right. Same thing, but this time bowlers. It's Harbhajan, Zaheer Khan, Shane Warne, Yasir Shah, Murli Dharan and Anil Kumble.
I think Shane Warne probably would take the top spot just for his artistry and, you know, the leg spin. I think leg spin was a dying art when he started. So, you know, and to be that consistent and, you know, so dominant as a leg spinner, I think was very hard. So he would take a top spot. I would say Murli Dharan purely because I don't see that record is going to get broken at all. 800 test wickets, that is not going to happen. Muralidharan would be second. I would say Kumble third, because I thought he was a match winner. You know, I think he was the biggest match winner India had, and he had limitations, but you know he exceeded those limitations. You know, by his mental ability and you know working through his limitation to achieve 600 plus test wickets. So I would say him. Zaheer and Harbhajan, I would say, they are pretty similar, so I would give them that number, whatever number that it is. And Yasir Shah would finish last.
All right. Last question. One advice to all the youngsters who are watching.
One advice I would give them is probably that there is no shortcuts to success. You need to work really hard. If you are a cricketer, if I am giving an advice to a cricketer, I would say that adapt to all three formats. Understand that test cricket is also important, even though there is a lot of money in IPL, a lot of glamour attached to T20 cricket. But I feel you need to give importance to all three formats. There are role models for you in front of you, as I mentioned, Virat Kohli, Rohit Sharma, Joe Root, Steve Smith, they fit into all formats. And the bowlers also, Pat Cummins, Rabada, Mitchell Starc, they fit into all formats. So you try and become, one of those who give importance to all three formats up until you are 30, 31, where your fitness allows you. Don't shy away from test cricket, don't shy away from day's cricket, and just, be happy playing wide ball cricket. There is no shortcuts to success. So work really hard. If you put in that much hard work, if you are that disciplined and devoted to your game, and if you put in that much effort into it, you are definitely going to succeed. So give yourself time, and with time you are going to achieve success.
I think that would mean a lot to every youngster who is watching this. Thank you so much, Wasim bhai, for being on the show and taking out time for us. It definitely means a lot to me and everybody at Sports Tiger. Congratulations once again for being appointed as the head coach. I wish you all well, and please stay in touch.
Thank you very much.
So 11,000 runs, 2,500s at an average of over 40. At 63, how does it feel to have conquered the sport with utmost authority?
I think the one thing we have to accept is there's always the human element.